One of the other interesting things from the genetics, especially in domesticated animals, is the so-called comparative genetics. Comparative genetics most of the time is done within a same group, like the mammals or the birds, but you can look even further. For example, the gene that gives a very short beak in the tumbler is a comparable gene what gives the very short face in dogs or in certain cat breeds. Another nice example, the short legs in the dachshund or the basset hound, is the same gene that gives short legs in a certain chicken breed. Now to compare mammals and birds is perhaps goes perhaps a little bit too far, but comparative genetics within birds and different species can be very interesting because it can show relationships between different species and different families. So domesticated animals are very easy, of course, to find and to compare. So when you look around, for example, when you look at this collar and keep this collar in mind, and when you are walking on the street somewhere and you see a certain collar of dog, this collar is present in dogs as well. This is called almond in pigeons. In the dog, it's called blue merle, I think. And you see it sometimes in collies. Comparable, the same gene, but in different species. And that is perhaps what genetics make interesting. Because not every mutation in a certain species is unique. Every mutation can occur in every species, but also shows that there is a relation between all species anyway.